This is the iPhone 16 Pro, which has Siri with Apple Intelligence. And this is the S25 Ultra with Google's Gemini integration. In today's video, I'm testing the assistant in these devices to see which one is better. So, let's start.
Okay, I just took a look at the image you sent.
So,
do you have any questions about the yoga bar?
Yeah, I'm diabetic. Can I eat this?
If you're managing diabetes, it's always best to check with your doctor or a registered dietitian before adding a new food to your diet, just to be safe. However, this bar is relatively low in sugar compared to other snack bars, and it has a good amount of protein and fiber, which can help regulate blood sugar levels.
Hey Siri, I'm diabetic. Can I eat this protein bar?
This protein bar contains 13.5 grams of carbohydrates and 11.9 grams of sugar per 50 gram serving. It's important to consider these amounts in the context of your dietary plan. Please consult your healthcare provider for personalized advice.
So, while both Siri and Gemini answered the question, I preferred Gemini's response as it not only shared more info, but the response also felt more suggestive or personalized. Now, let's ask them something else.
It looks like you've got all the ingredients for a delicious salad. What kind of dressing do you like?
So, I want to eat something healthy for the dinner. Can you please suggest me what can I make with these ingredients?
Sure, let's see. How about a mushroom and spinach fritter? It's a great way to use up those ingredients, and it's packed with protein and iron. You could also make a delicious tomato and spinach soup.
Now, let's try Siri. Hey Siri, what can I make with this ingredients?
Here's an answer from ChatGPT.
So, Gemini not only suggested me what to cook, but it also engaged me further by asking me what dressing I'd like. It also gave me some other good suggestions after that. On the other hand, Siri with Apple Intelligence used ChatGPT and it only gave a written response. So, Gemini wins this one.
This looks like a blister pack for Rabisec DSR capsules. Do you have any questions about this medication?
Yeah, I want to know what is this used for.
Rabisec DSR contains two medications, rabeprazole, which helps reduce stomach acid, and domperidone, which aids in digestion. It's commonly used to treat ulcers, gastroesophageal reflux disease.
Hey Siri, what's the use of this medicine?
Domperidone is primarily used to relieve nausea and vomiting,
and it can also improve gastric motility, making it helpful for conditions like gastritis and GERD.
Both Siri and Gemini answered what the medicine is and what it's used for, so it's a tie.
Hey Siri, summarize the plot of movie Inception.
Do you want me to use ChatGPT to answer that?
Yeah, sure.
Here's an answer from ChatGPT.
Okay, Google, summarize the plot of movie Inception.
Inception is a complex science fiction film centered around the concept of dream sharing and manipulating the subconscious. Here's a summarized plot. Dom Cobb, Leonardo DiCaprio, is a skilled extractor, a thief who steals corporate secrets.
Hey Siri, can you help me understand this?
This text is discussing the concept of heuristics, which are mental shortcuts or rules of thumb that people use to make decisions and solve problems quickly. The book explains how these heuristics can influence consumer behavior.
All right, I can see the article now. How can I help?
Can you please help me understand this concept?
Sure. So basically, this is about how people take shortcuts when they have to make a decision. And a common shortcut is believing that if something has a lot of information behind it, it must be true.
So, Siri with Apple Intelligence just showed a written summary of the movie, and it also answered the other queries with kind of generic responses, which lacked the personalization that Gemini adds to it. So, in the AI queries and advanced responses, Gemini takes the win. Now, let's test their GK and conversational skills.
Hey Siri, is it going to rain tomorrow?
It doesn't look like it's going to rain tomorrow.
Okay Google, is it going to rain tomorrow?
In Dehradun, it'll be mostly sunny, with a high of 23 and a low of 11.
Hey Siri, who won the FIFA World Cup in 2022?
After a 3-3 tie in extra time, Argentina defeated France 4-2 in penalty kicks in the finals of the FIFA World Cup.
Okay Google, who won the FIFA World Cup in 2022?
After the game ended with the teams tied 3-3, France lost to Argentina 4-2 in penalties. On December 17, 2022, Morocco lost to Croatia 2-1. On December 15, 2022, Morocco lost to France 2-0.
Hey Siri, translate nice to meet you into French.
In French, nice to meet you is
ravi de te rencontrer.
Okay Google, translate nice to meet you into French.
There are a few ways to translate nice to meet you into French, depending on the context and level of formality. Enchanté, this is a very common and polite option. Enchanté is used by a man and enchanté by a woman. Ravi de vous rencontrer. This is a more formal option, meaning delighted to meet you.
So, both answered the weather and sports query and both translated the phrase, and even though Gemini did provide a more detailed translation, I'll give this one a draw. By the way, if you were wondering how Gemini performs against Samsung's Bixby, then tap on the I button to watch Gemini vs. Bixby Assistant battle. Now, let's try giving them some daily tasks.
Hey Siri, I'll be making quinoa salad for the dinner. Please save its recipe as a note.
Done!
Okay Google, I'll be making quinoa salad for the dinner. Please save its recipe as a note.
Alright, I created a new note called Quinoa Salad Recipe.
Hey Siri, set a reminder to take medicine at 5 PM and set two following reminders at 10-minute intervals.
Okay, I added it.
Okay Google, set a reminder to take medicine at 5 PM and set two following reminders at 10-minute intervals.
Alright, you want to create these three tasks. Do you want to go ahead and create them right now?
Yes.
Okay, everything's done.
Hey Siri, tell me the best flights from Dehradun to Bangalore on 25th Feb.
Do you want me to use ChatGPT to answer that?
Search the web. Okay Google, tell me the best flight from Dehradun to Bangalore on 25th Feb.
The cheapest flight from Dehradun to Bangalore on February 25th is with IndiGo, with a layover in Indore, IDR, departing at 5:30 PM and arriving at 11 PM, costing 19,013 rupees.
Hey Siri, remind me to charge the phone when the battery level goes to 20%.
Okay, I added it.
Okay Google, remind me to charge the phone when the battery level reaches 20%.
Okay, I added it.
Sorry, I can't set a reminder based on a percentage of battery level.
Gemini, it saved the recipe as a note, it understood and performed the complex reminder commands, and it also showed all the possible flight details. Whereas Apple Intelligence and Siri is lagging behind. It couldn't save the recipe as a note, it didn't save the reminders, and it only showed me the flight details on the web. However, it saved the battery percentage reminder, which Gemini straight up refused to do. Let's try giving them some other commands.
Hey Siri, call Nitin.
Just to confirm, you'd like to call Nitin?
Yeah. Okay Google, call Nitin.
Did you want to call Nitin?
Yeah.
Calling Nitin.
Hey Siri, send a message to Nitin.
What do you want to say?
Hey man, let's meet at 5 p.m.
Do you want to change it or send it?
Send it.
It's sent.
Okay, Google. Send a message to Nathan.
What's the message?
Hey man, let's meet at 5 p.m.
Alright, message to Nitin saying, hey man, let's meet at 5 p.m. Ready to send it?
Send.
Sending it now.
Hey Siri, open YouTube and play Faded by Alan Walker. Okay Google, open YouTube and play Faded by Alan Walker.
Here's Alan Walker's Faded song on YouTube. Alan Walker Faded, lyrics by Seven Clouds, Alan Walker.
Hey Siri, start navigation to the nearest Starbucks.
Which Starbucks?
The first one.
Getting directions to Starbucks.
Okay Google, start navigation to the nearest Starbucks.
Head north, then slide right.
So, after putting Gemini and Siri with Apple Intelligence head-to-head, it's clear that both the assistants excel in different areas. Gemini shines when it comes to AI creativity and advanced responses. It provides more detailed, personalized and engaging answers, making interactions feel more intuitive and personal. Whether it's suggesting meals based on available ingredients or helping with medical queries, Gemini feels more like a conversation partner rather than just being an information retriever. However, while it is deeply integrated with Google's ecosystem, it still struggles with some basic hands-free controls or playing specific YouTube videos. Siri with Apple Intelligence, on the other hand, is still playing catch-up in the AI department. While it does use ChatGPT for complex queries, its responses feel less dynamic compared to Gemini. However, where Siri really excels in is in smart actions and hands-free control. It seamlessly executes commands like calling, messaging, and navigation without a hitch, whereas Gemini occasionally fails at these. That said, Siri struggles with advanced AI reminders and personalized AI tasks, showing its limitations compared to Gemini's contextual understanding. As AI continues to evolve, it will be interesting to see how both assistants improve over time. But for now, if I have to choose one to use as my personal assistant, then I would pick Gemini over Siri with Apple Intelligence. And with that, I'll wrap up this one. If you enjoyed the video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Gizmo Rush for more cool comparisons, reviews and more. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Till then, take care and goodbye.